the weird weather we have now is not the fire, it's sort of like the fire alarm.
Smog yesterday in Beijing, the highest level they had seen in quite some time.
Wildfires are burning out of control in San Diego County.
This is the worst drought to hit South Africa since 1982.
As you know, in Houston, they are dealing with deadly flooding, and unfortunately, the death toll has now risen to 7.
This agreement represents the best chance we've had to save the one planet that we've got.
I don't think any of the proposals that have been put forward in the Paris talks are sufficient to, by themselves, save the planet. It's really only acknowledgement of a problem. What it means in terms of carbon and energy is that we have to shut things down much more quickly. If it had turned out that there had been less carbon dioxide in the atmosphere when we discovered coal, all the climate changes that we are getting now could have happened earlier in time. It's sort of like you light a fuse and it burns for a couple centuries before it gets to the bomb and blows up. And it could have very easily been that with a different atmosphere, it would have been a shorter fuse. Right now, emissions are growing exponentially, but if we ramp down the emissions at some rate, at some point, you know, it'll become negligible and you can add up the total amount of carbon that we've ever released. And that's what determines how much the climate changes. If we've already released enough to get to 1 degree C, we can release another half again as much as that to get to 1.5 degrees C. Actually, what it also means is what they call negative emissions, which is fancy language for cleaning up our mess. Technologically, we can do it. We could do it, no problem. We're very smart people. We set up the financial incentives, and lots of smart people will make lots of money figuring out how to supply us energy. The hard part is making the decision to do it when it becomes a collective situation, a global problem that becomes politically harder to deal with. I'm not a political scientist, so I can't say how hard or easy it is to make a decision, but I can say that that's all that it is. So as a physical scientist, it sounds to me like a piece of cake.